Question 1. Two planets have same average density, but their radii are R1 and R2. If the acceleration due to gravity on these planets are g1 and g2 respectively, then we know g is equal to gm upon r square, where g upon r square is equal into 4 upon 3 pi r cube rho. So g is equal to 4 upon 3 pi r rho g. G is directly proportional to r. 4 upon 3 pi g is a constant, and both have same densities. Now, g1 upon g2 will be r1 upon r2. So g1 upon g2 is equal to r1 upon r2. Option D is the correct answer. Question 2. If the density of the Earth increases 4 times and its radius becomes half of what it is, then our weight will be, weight is equal to mg. Weight is directly proportional to g, as mass is constant. G is equal to 4 upon 3 pi r rho g. So g is directly proportional to rho r. So g dash upon g is equal to 4 rho upon rho multiplied by r upon 2r, which gives us 2. So g dash upon g is equal to 2. So g dash is equal to 2g. Therefore the weight will be doubled. Weight will be doubled. So option D, be doubled, is the correct answer. Question 3. A man can jump 2 meters high on the surface of the earth. How high he can jump on a planet where the acceleration due to gravity is g by 2n, where g is the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the earth. Now to solve this question, we know the energy required by man to jump up to a height h is given by E is equal to W, which is equal to mgh, which is also equal to mg dash h dash. So h dash is equal to g upon g dash h. But we know g upon g dash is given as g by 12 into height is 2. So this will be 24 meter. So option C, 24 meter, is the correct answer. 4. The densities of two planets are in the ratio of 2:3 and their radii are in the ratio 1:2. What is the ratio of acceleration due to gravity at their surfaces? So now we know g is equal to gm upon r square. So g upon r square into 4 upon 3 pi r cube d, that is volume into density, which is equal to 4 upon 3 pi g r d. So g1 upon g2 is equal to r1 d1 upon r2 d2, which is equal to 1 upon 2 into 2 by 3, which on solving we get 1 by 3. So the ratio is 1:3. Option A, 1:3, is the correct answer. 5. The height at which the acceleration due to gravity becomes g by 9, where g is acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the earth in terms of r, where r is the radius of the earth, is. Now to solve this question, we know g is equal to gm upon r square and g dash is equal to gm upon r plus h the whole square. G dash upon g is 1 by 9 is equal to gm upon r plus h square into r square upon gm, r square upon r plus h square. So now 9r square is equal to r plus h square. 3r is equal to r plus h, taking square root on both sides. So h will be 2r. So option D, 2r, is the correct answer. Question 6. Two spheres of masses m and m minus 1 are prepared from a sphere of mass capital M. They are kept at a distance x. For what ratio of m upon capital M will the gravitational attraction between them be maximum? So we know gravitational force of attraction between two spheres is F is equal to g m m minus m upon x square, which is equal to g m m upon x square minus g m square upon x square. The force, for the force to be maximum, df upon dm is equal to 0. Df upon dm is equal to gm upon x square minus 2gm upon x square, which is equal to 0. So gm upon x square is equal to 2gm upon x square. So value for m, capital M is equal to 2m, or m upon capital M is equal to 1/2. So option C, 1/2 is the correct answer. Question 7. The mass of spherical planet is 5 times the mass of Earth, but its diameter is the same as that of the Earth. How much work is done in lifting a stone of mass 3 kg through a distance of 1 meter on the planet? So now we know G on the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the Earth is given by G is equal to Gm upon R square. For a planet, it is G dash is equal to Gm dash upon R dash square, which is equal to G into 5m upon R square. So G dash upon G is equal to 5. Therefore, G dash is equal to 5g. Work done in lifting the stone through a distance 1 meter is W is equal to m g dash h 5 m g h 5 into 3 into 10 into 1, which is equal to 150 joules. So option B, 150 joules is the correct answer. Question number 8. If the radius of the Earth were to be decreased by 1%, its mass remaining the same, the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the Earth will be G is equal to Gm upon R square. G is inversely proportional to R square. Hence, G will be increased if R is decreased. So now, log G is equal to log of capital G plus log of capital M minus 2 log R. Differentiating this, we get dg upon g is equal to 0 plus 0 minus 2 dr upon r. G and m are constant. So dg upon g multiplied by 100 is equal to minus 2 dr upon r multiplied by 100, which is equal to minus 2 into minus 1%, which gives us 2%. Therefore, g will increase, or g will increase by 2%. So increases by 2%. Option C is the correct answer. 9. A body weighs 45 newton on the surface of the Earth. What is the gravitational force acting on it due to the Earth at the height equal to half the radius of the Earth? Now to solve this question, we know g dash is equal to g r square upon r plus h square, which is equal to g r square upon r plus r by 2 ka square, which is equal to g r square into 4 upon 9 r square, which is equal to 4/9 g. On the surface of earth, W is equal to mg, it is equal to mg, which is equal to 45 newton. Height is equal to r by 2. So W dash is equal to mg dash, which is equal to 49 mg, which is equal to 49 into 45, which gives us 20 newton. So option C, 20 newton, is the correct answer. Question 10. A planet has the same size as that of the Earth, but its mass is 4 times the mass of the Earth. What is the energy required to lift a stone of mass 5 kg vertically upwards through 3 meters on the planet? G on the surface of the Earth is 10 meters per second square. Now to solve this question, we know on the Earth, G is equal to Gm upon R square. On the planet, G dash is equal to Gm dash upon R dash square. M dash is equal to 4 times M and R is equal to R dash. So G dash upon G is equal to G 4M into R square multiplied by R square upon Gm, which gives us 4. Therefore, G dash is equal to 4 times G, which is equal to 40 meter per second square. Energy required. Energy is MgH. 5 into 40 into h, h value for h is 3, which gives us 600 joules. So option D, 600 joules, is the correct answer. Question 11. Suppose that the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the moon is 0.2 times the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the Earth. Re is the maximum horizontal range of the projectile on the surface of the Earth. What is the maximum horizontal range on the surface of the moon for the same velocity of projection. For the Earth, maximum horizontal range, Re is equal to V square upon GE. For the Moon, it is Rm is equal to V square upon Gm. So Rm upon Re is equal to GE upon Gm, which is equal to GE upon 0.2 times GE, which is equal to 5. Therefore, Rm upon Re is equal to 5. So Rm is equal to 5 times Re. So 5 times Re is the correct answer. 12. The orbital velocity of an artificial satellite in a circular orbit just above the Earth's surface is V0. For a satellite orbiting at altitude of half of Earth's radius, the orbital velocity is, now we know, V0 is square root of Gm upon R. V0 dash is equal to square root of Gm upon 3 by 2 R. V0 dash is equal to square root of 2 by 3 V0. So square root of 2 by 3 V0 is the correct answer. Option B is the correct answer. Question 13. The orbital velocity for an Earth satellite near the surface of the Earth is 8 km per second. If the radius of the orbit is 4 times the radius of the Earth, its orbital velocity will be. Now to solve this question, we know V is equal to square root of Gm upon R. So V1 upon V2 is equal to square root of R2 upon R1, which is equal to square root of 4 upon 1, which is equal to 2. Therefore, V2 is equal to V1 by 2. Value for V1 was 8 km per second. So 8 by 2, which will give us 4 km per second. So option C, 4 km per second is the correct answer. 14. If the radius of the Earth's orbit is made 1/4 of its present value, then the duration of the year will be. Now to solve this question, we know T1 square upon T2 square is equal to R1 cube upon R1 upon 4 cube, which is 64 upon 1, which is equal to 4 cube. So T1 upon T2 is equal to 4 raised to 3 by 2. So T1 upon T2 is equal to 8. So T2 will be T1 by 8, which is equal to 365 upon 8 days. So option D, 365 upon 8 days is the correct answer. Question 15. Two satellites X and Y are moving in a circular orbit of radii R and 2R respectively around the same planet. What is the ratio of their critical velocities? So we know Vx upon Vy is equal to square root of Gm upon R into 2R upon Gm, which gives us square root of 2 upon 1. So option D, root 2 is to 1 is the correct answer. Question 16. Two satellites orbiting around the Earth having their critical speed in the ratio 4:5, what is the ratio of the orbital radii? So we know VC1 upon VC2 is equal to square root of R2 upon R1. So R1 upon R2 is equal to VC2 upon VC1 the whole square, which is equal to 5 by 4 square, which is equal to 25 upon 16. So option C, 25 upon 16 is the correct answer. 17. The critical speed of the satellite orbiting very close to the surface of the Earth is, now we know for the satellite orbiting very close to the surface of the Earth, critical speed VE is equal to square root of Gm upon R, but Gm is equal to GR square, VC is equal to square root of GR square upon R, which is equal to square root of GR, which is equal to square root of 10 into 6.4 into 10 raised to 6. VC is equal to square root of 64 into 10 raised to 6, which gives us 8 into 10 raised to 3 meter per second. So option A, 8 into 10 raised to 3 meter per second is the correct answer. 18. Two satellites are moving at height of R and 5R above the surface of the Earth of radius capital R. The ratio of their velocities V1 upon V2 is, now we know V1 upon V2 is equal to square root of Gm upon 2R upon square root of Gm upon 6R, which is equal to square root of 3 upon 1. So option D, root 3 is to 1 is the correct answer. Question 19. If rho is the mean density of the Earth and R is its radius, then the critical speed of the satellite revolving very close to the surface of the Earth is, now VC is equal to square root of Gm upon R, which is equal to square root of G 4 pi r cube rho upon 3r, which is equal to 2r square root of g pi rho upon 3. So option A, 2r square root of g pi rho upon 3 is the correct answer. Question 20. What would be the duration of the year if the distance between Earth and the Sun gets doubled? Assume the Earth's orbit to be circular. So we know according to Kepler's law, t square is directly proportional to r cube. So t2 upon t1 square is equal to r2 upon r1 cube, which is equal to 2 upon 1 cube, which is equal to 8. So t1 upon t2 is equal to square root of 8, which is equal to 2 root 2. So value for t2 will be 2 root 2 into t1. T2 upon T1. T2 will be 2 root 2 into T1, which is 365 into 2 into 1.414, which I'm solving, we get 1032 days. So option A, 1032 is the correct answer. Question 21. Two satellites of mass 80 kg and 120 kg revolve around the planet in a circular orbit of radii 16R and 9R respectively. Where r is the radius of the planet, the ratio of the speed of the satellite will be. Now we know v1 upon v2 is equal to square root of gm upon 16r into 9r upon gm, which gives us square root of 9 upon 16, which is equal to 3 by 4. So option D, 3 by 4 is the correct answer. Question 22. The critical speed of satellite of mass 500 kg is 20 meter per second. What is the critical speed of the satellite of mass 1000 kg moving in the same orbit? Vc is independent of the mass of the satellite. Vc is equal to 20 meter per second, which is equal to 20 into 3600 meter per hour, which is equal to 72,000 meter per hour, which is equal to 72 kilometer per hour. So option D, 72 km per hour is the correct answer. Question 23. A planet revolves in an elliptical orbit around the sun. The kinetic energy of the planet will be maximum at. According to conservation of angular momentum, we know I1 omega 1 is equal to I2 omega 2. So m r1 square omega 1 is equal to m r2 square omega 2. R1 square V1 upon R1 is equal to R2 square V2 upon R2, which is equal to V1 R1 is equal to V2 R2. At D, R is minimum. At D, R is minimum. Therefore, V is maximum. Therefore, kinetic energy is maximum. So, option D is the correct answer. 24. A body weighs W Newton on the surface of the Earth. Its weight and height equal to half the radius of the Earth will be. Now, we know g dash is equal to g r square upon r plus r by 2 the whole square, which is equal to 4 by 9 g. W dash is equal to m g dash, which is equal to 4 by 9 m g, which is equal to 4 by 9 w. So option C, 4 by 9 w is the correct answer. A satellite of mass m revolves around the Earth of radius r at a height x from the surface. If g is the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of the Earth, then orbital speed of the satellite is. So now we know orbital speed v0 is equal to gm upon square root of gm upon r plus x, which is equal to g r square upon r plus x. Square root of gr square upon r plus x. So option A, gr square upon r plus x raised to 1 by 2 is the correct answer. Question 26. An artificial satellite of mass small m is orbiting around the Earth of mass capital M in an orbit of radius r0 with a constant angular velocity. What is the angular momentum of the satellite? Now to solve this question, we know angular momentum is equal to linear momentum into perpendicular distance between two, which is equal to mass into orbital velocity into radius,
which is equal to n into square root of gm upon r0 into r0,
which is equal to
n square root of
gm r0. So option B, m square root of
gm r0,
is the correct answer. 27. Two planets are at mean distances d1 and d2 from the sun. If n1 and n2 are the frequencies of revolution around the sun,
then
so we know t square is directly proportional to
d cube.
T is equal to 1 by n. 1 upon n is directly proportional to d cube,
where n square d cube is constant.
So n1 square d1 cube
is equal to
n2 square d2 cube. So option C, n1 square d1 cube is equal to n2 square d2 cube, is the correct answer. 28. Two satellites of masses m and 4m are orbiting the Earth in a circular orbit of radius r. Their frequency of revolution r in the ratio of,
so we know t is equal to 2 pi square root of r cube upon gm. The period and n are independent of mass,
therefore the ratio is also 1 is to 1. So option D, 1 is to 1, is the correct answer. Question 29. The distance of two planets A and B from the sun are 10 raised to 12 meter and 10 raised to 11 meter, and the periodic times are TA and TB respectively. If the orbits are assumed to be circular, then the ratio of their periodic times TA upon TB will be. So now we know
TA upon TB
square
is equal to
10 raised to 12 upon 10 raised to 11,
which is equal to 10 raised to 3,
which is equal to 1000. Using Kepler's law, t square is directly proportional to r cube.
So TA upon TB
is equal to
square root of 1000,
which is equal to 10 root
10.
So option C, 10 root 10, is the correct answer. Question 30. A planet revolves around the sun 8 times faster than the Earth. Then the ratio of the distance of the planet from the sun to distance of the Earth
from the sun is. Now to solve this question, we know t square directly proportional to r cube.
So n1 square
d1 cube is equal to
n2 square
d2 cube.
So n1 upon n2
square is equal to
d2 upon d1
cube,
which is equal to 8 upon 1 cube. So d2 upon
d1 is equal to 2 raised to 3 raised to 2 by 3,
which is equal to 4. So d1 upon d2
is equal to 1 by
4. So option D, 1 is to 4, is the correct answer.